castle, go castle. ёбаный в рот. Блять. Пиздато. Охуенно просто. Просто лучший. О, нормально. Нихуя себе, Вайс.
Well, woman manager.
Ай-яй-яй-яй. Ну, блядь, висать нахуй. Да ты сука! сука! Выслеживал меня. Куда этот хуй смотрел? Пять раз надо сделать, взять, да? Да, это не просто будет. Джерри! capa.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Today, as the Golden State Warriors come in for this one. Great to have you with us, everybody, live on 2K Sports. Along with Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge. On our sidelines, this is Kevin Harlan, and joining us tonight. Routine's coming to an end. We're just about ready for our tip-off. First, though, let's get a report from the sideline and say hello to David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, Klay Thompson continues to be happy with his role in the...
Thanks, David. That's the mindset you have to have. In the end, winning titles should be the ultimate goal. Kevin, one of the biggest moments of your career, the 2008 championship with the Boston Celtics. Talk about the camaraderie among that group of players.
You know, Kev, I can tell right away that we had something special getting together right in September, right before the year started. We started working out together. We started sharing concepts and how we saw the game. Right away, I can tell that the appetite was there. 1 through 15 guys. It's very rare that she was able to get that many guys in that early. As soon as Danny, you know, signed guys, we were in, we were lifting, we was just, you know, around each other, mm-hmm. understanding each other, you know, playing a lot. We was playing a lot. Then, fortunately, we was able to go off to Rome that year. Rome was a good distraction for us because we had to lean on one another.
To bond a little bit.
Seriously, because, yeah. you know, none of us spoke Italian. You know, if we wanted to go somewhere, we was always 3-4 deep, and no one was asking and no one was telling us to be with each other. We were just naturally being with each other so much that whenever you saw us to the restaurants, 9-10 of us, that carried over to practice. Then we got two teams that are very competitive. Doc's letting us be who we want to be, and he letting us play with passion, and our practices are over the top aggressive and to the point where it's too competitive, to where he has to come in and separate us and, you know, take the balls and cut the lights out and get us out of here, to the point where he just lets us go. Now we start bringing concepts to him. He start trusting our IQs. Now we start putting a couple things on defense. Thibodeau's in there. He's implementing stuff. I mean, this flow is going like this. You don't know that you're going to win it all, but you know you're on the waves of something special, right. And that's how they felt.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. So for the Golden State Warriors right now, the sharpshooters Curry and Thompson are at the one and the two. It's small ball with Iguodala and Green down low. And it's Durant in at the small forward position. Down to five on the shot clock. And there's the call on Gordon Hayward. That's his first foul. And KG, talk about how the greats can just impose their will.
It's almost like another level. Yeah. When you see LeBron, what he did to Detroit in that fourth quarter, that's a blackout. You don't know what you're doing. When you see Cole go for 81, when you see Chauncey come down on a one, these players are blacking out. These are elite players in elite moments, taking the moment. Paul Pierce is one of the best that I've ever seen grab a moment and savor it and just put it in slow-mo. And nothing speeding them up.
Special players.
Special players. Bro, I get a front row seat of seeing them. Ray Allen, the same thing. Had a great composure about himself to slow himself down and hit pressure shots. Tim Duncan, same thing.
Just great work from Hayward to collect loose change. A high motor player who keeps his energy up during every possession.
The Warriors have gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Curry, wide open. And another three for Golden State. Kevin, we see some coaches get extremely emotional on the sideline. Others take a more even-keeled approach, more calm on the sideline. Which coaching style would you prefer to play for when you were in your prime? Did you want a coach who was animated, or did you want a coach that was just kind of settled on the sideline?
You know what? I like the coach that was settled on the sideline. Uh-huh. You know, I like to think that great coaches are going to be able to coach you in practice. And then during the games, you know, it's about the product and what you put out on the floor. Yes. You know, coaches that have understanding, coaches that have vision, coaches that understand the game, know, understand that it's a game of runs, know that it's a game of momentum, and has plays for those moments and those times. A coach that I've always gravitated to and understood that they...
Like Doc was kind of in between, wasn't he? A little bit of emotion, but he could also have a calm demeanor on that side.
Doc was all fire, I'm sorry. Doc, there was nothing calming about Doc.
I'm trying to
Doc.
Cover Doc's back here.
No, shout to Doc. Doc would rip your head off if you wasn't supposed to. But you know what? You need to play with that edge. You needed to know that if you wasn't in your spot, 1 through 15, you understood that you were supposed to be there. And it's good to play with that. I think that you don't want to be out there playing like, you know, this is no big deal. Every play is a big deal. And no play, you
play
absolutely. Absolutely. And you know what? That severity.
ты просто ебаный пидор, блядь. Сука, животные, блядь, все заебали нахуй. Дайте сесть. Блять, а почему в ППП не сыграть в натуре?